Should we hear some Vox?
For sure, yeah. We can, yeah.
Should we do Vox and then we can turn the drive up a little bit more? We'll get some more of those crunchy tones?
Yeah.
Vinny, does that suit with you? Viewers on Facebook, does that suit with you? Good, excellent. Yeah. Let's do.
Cool. We can always come back if we want.
Of course
to, like,
we can.
Maybe some stuff if there's, you know,
absolutely
and stuff. We can check out the.
This is in no way planned out. We can do whatever we want.
It's all good. All right. So yeah, next up we've got the Vox
AC15. Beautiful
AC15. Really nice. As far as I know, there's like an Alnico style speaker in it, which is a very important part of the Vox sound.
Yep.
So I've replicated that in the Helix as well.
Perfect.
But yeah, let's just listen to the reamp on its own first.
So. To hear it with just a little bit of sort of Klon-esque magic sauce on it. A pretty much unity gain, just adding a little bit. Here's my challenge to the Helix. What you hear a lot of there, that for me a Vox has this, and it's this class A kind of response, mm-hmm. where you could probably hear Sean's playing. Hopefully it translates through the live stream, but actually it can be pretty clean when you backed off.
Yeah.
But when you were digging in, you could get really, really angry.
For sure, yeah. So, that's a huge part of that sound. It's so responsive and like to your volume knob as well, and how you play
your pick hitting it, the thing. So I'm now very interested to hear if this box of witchcraft can do similar.
Yeah, absolutely. Cool. So switch over to the Helix. Here we go.
Was exactly that, and that's with no Klon-esque kind of.
Yeah,
that's just the Vox AC amp on there.
It's basically straight into the amp.
The response was so similar,
like, very similar. Yeah, I think the real amp was maybe just a little bit more overdriven.
Yeah,
so I can try and maybe bridge that a little bit by bringing the drive up a small bit more.
One thing that I'm definitely noticing in the ears, because of the way that we've set this up, is the Helix has definitely got more of a drier sound to it, because I think it's a lot more direct. So if you wanted to get that kind of like natural room sound from the amp, like that's doable as well with the Helix as well, right?
For sure, actually. Yeah. I'll show you that straight away, because there's a new reverb that was brought into the Helix in the 3.5 firmware update, which was quite a large update for the Helix. It had a redesigned cabinet engine, which has made a huge difference to the sonic possibilities in the Helix. But the reverb was this thing called the dynamic ambience. So basically what this is the ambience of a room. So especially when you've got an amp turned up as loud as we have here with these three, the mic is going to be picking up that signal, but it's also going to be picking up a little bit of the
reflections.
Which does add to the sound. Has a huge impact on the sound, actually, because it's...
Yeah, definitely. You
know, it's the worlds that the amp
is. I think that is, in its simplest form, that's the amp in a room, mm-hmm. kind of, you know, when you say, oh, you know, does it sound like an amp that's just behind you? I think that's it, isn't it?
100%, 100%. And that's the big thing. The difference between an amp in the room, as we're actually hearing it today, so say we're listening to the Vox, it's probably 4 or 5 feet away from us.
Yeah.
We're not hearing what the microphone is hearing. We're hearing what our ears are hearing, slightly above it and slightly away from it. Whereas if we had our ears right up close to it...
Well, we'd be deaf.
We'd be deaf. It wouldn't be a good start,
that's no. It.
But the microphone is picking up a very direct capture of that, plus the direction, or the reflections from the room. So, yeah, this dynamic ambience, if I play something really percussive, we're probably hearing that in the room too, but I'll increase the mix of it so on the stream people can hear a bit more of what it's doing. So this is 100% mix.
Oh, okay. We're in a super reflective tiled bathroom.
Exactly, yeah. Super, tiley, quite a bright sounding, brittle room. But if we had room mics in this room, that's what it would sound like as well, you know?
So if you back that mix down slightly,
so
to say...
I'd say 50%.
Yeah.
Just going to add a little bit.
You can really you can really hear that. That's you can hear the difference that's made.
I think that that definitely adds that more kind of real sound to it. Can we just hear like one after the other straight away just to kind of hear and just for anyone watching at home as well, just to kind of clarify how we're running this. The Helix is coming direct into the mixer, and the amps are being mic'd up straight into the mixer as well. So that's how we've mic'd it up. We do have a power cab in the room, but the power cab isn't actually being used for any of the sounds coming through the stream. Just in case anyone's wondering, because a couple people were asking questions about the power cab.
Cool, nice one. So yeah, let's go back to the reel amp for a second.
Yeah.
So
you've got Tumnus on as well. Is that good?
Actually, yeah, and I'll put the similar drive on that then as well. So, yeah, here's the reel amp.
Oh, I had one job. Pickup as well. That's like the sound of my childhood to like indie rock records from Manchester.
That's actually why I love those amps so much. Like, I'm not a shredder guitar player. I love playing indie tunes, you know.
Songs that impress people at pies.
Exactly.
Yeah. Easy.
Bit of Wonderwall.
Oh, knock it out. Come on, let's get going. Messing around with all these amps. Let's get some Oasis riffs on the go.
That's it. So yeah, I'll hop over to... I'll just really quickly again, just because we were chatting between it, I'll go...
And then we'll get...
And then we'll and I'll, yeah, switch back again. So here's the Vox. Now here's the Helix.
That response is so close.
It's pretty close.
That because I can hear how light or hard you're digging into the strings.
Yeah.
So just to hear it so, let's say the response so similar between the two is
pretty cool.
Like, that's genuinely impressive.